and use my speech to set the bar up, and it's too much hectic, and then deal with the others fairly. I'm sure we're all frustrated by the response from the federal and state governments to the climate global emergency that we have. It's really, could not be more stark. The challenge we have and the response we're getting are so far apart. And yet, the community is very driven to embrace renewable energy and to embrace energy efficiency. I mean, look what we've done, despite the fact that they're backpedaling and putting as much frustration in our way as possible. It's really remarkable what the community has been able to achieve. Imagine what we can achieve if we get people in Parliament who are prepared to favour renewable energy, prepared to put decent money into energy efficiency and to ending our fossil fuel addiction. It's not surprising we have the response we do from the federal government or any of the other governments around the country, because millions of dollars goes into the pockets of political parties from the fossil fuel industry. And most of that is completely under the radar, does not have to be acknowledged. There's no transparency under $100,000. So we have Liberal parties bankrolled to, I think, the tune of $10 million by the fossil fuel industry, and Labor also taking a lot of this dirty money. You add into that some short-sighted union input into the Labor position, and this is what we get. Is it any surprise then that we have, throughout this campaign, an almost silence on climate issues from the major parties? And without a specific commitment from Labor, it looks like forming government, then I think we have to assume that we're going to have no commitment to close coal-fired power stations in Victoria, no commitment to rule out brown coal exports, no ruling out of coal seam gas fracking, and no restoration of a fair feed-in tariff for solar. And that is so disappointing. Then we have the Greens, who must be said have much better credentials on this, both with their policy and their performance. But still, they have failed to come up with a clear commitment against corporate donations that do undermine our efforts. And now, through their preferences, a vote for them in the upper house up here will be a vote for the sex party. So they've preferenced three parties that do not have climate change credentials, and I suggest that whilst you may wish to vote for them in the lower house, and that would be a strong climate message, really voting for the Greens in the upper house is not a viable option here. Now, I've been a campaigner on climate for many, many years. I'm going to show my age. When I worked at ACF in the late 80s, I remember Barry Pittock coming in and explaining climate change, and really in many different ways my activities have gone on for those past 25, 30 years. I was central to the elimination of halos in Australia that were damaging our ozone layer. I've been involved in many community solar projects. I think there are 8 projects that are either completed or underway that I've had a major role in. I've played a key role in getting the government feed-in tariff increased from 2 kilowatt limit to a 5 kilowatt limit by jumping up on my roof and threatening to take down my panels, getting the front page of the AGM, getting an amendment in the legislation in Parliament. So that's what I've done, and a whole lot more. What am I going to do in the future? Because that's really the test. If you put me in Parliament, the issues I'm raising, we need 1,000 solar units on low-income households. We need green power for our rail network. We need to block Labor legislation if they dare to undermine their position on the East-West Tollway. And I will take all the legislative and any other action I can to end our coal addiction. I'll introduce a private members' bill as soon as I get in there to end corporate political donations so we can end that connection. And we're going to see an end to the $10,000 meals to get an ear of the minister that undermines so many good decisions. So we're getting very close to election day, and I just want you to think very closely. closely about how you're going to vote in the lighthouse, and then when you get to the big yellow paper, find that group in. It doesn't have a party next to it because I'm an independent, but I'm the strongest climate action candidate you'll have. Thank you.